So, good morning, both of you.
Good
Good
morning,
morning,
ma'am.
So, let's continue with our revision. Okay. So, in this, after the revision, we have to go through all the topics, including MySQL. So, your classes will be only till Tuesday, I guess. Mode. One is interactive mode, and another one is script mode, isn't it? That is over. Now we'll see Python fundamentals. What are the different character sets, keywords, literals, etc., etc. We'll just go through it again, once again. Before you can read.
Python is a high-level, interpreted, and general-purpose dynamic programming language that focuses on code readability. The syntax in Python helps the programmers to do coding in fewer steps as compared to Java or C++. The language founded in the year 1991 by the developer Guido van Rossum has programming easy and fun to do.
This we have seen. Okay. Vipul can read.
What is character set? Character set is a bunch of identifying elements in the programming language.
Right. So that is, you have to study what is a character set. Continue.
Letters A to Z or small letter A to small letter Z. Digits from 0 to 9. Special symbols like space, plus, minus, slash, brackets, round brackets, square brackets, not equal to, equal to, and
that is for new line and drop. Okay, the special characters, then white spaces, we'll read it that way. Yeah.
White spaces, blank spaces, horizontal tab, vertical tab, carriage return. Other characters are Python can process all 256, ASCII, and Unicode characters.
ASCII characters.
ASCII characters and Unicode characters.
Thank you.
What is token? Individual elements that are identified by programming language are called token or lexical unit.
So this can be the different question. What is a token? You may get a question like this. What are the different types of tokens?
One, keywords. Two, identifiers. Three, literals. Four, operators. Five, punctuators.
So these are the different types of tokens. Right? Don't know what are the different tokens?
Keywords, literals, identifiers. Literals, identifiers. Punctuators. Operators.
So these are the different keywords in Python. Few keywords. These are all keywords. If you see these keywords, that means in your question paper, there is a question like identify the valid identifiers. So we have to see properly whether the given options are keywords or not. If it is keyword, that means you should not give it as an answer. The question can be find out the different identifiers, or the question can be find out the different word which can't be used as identifier. So the both the ways the question can be asked. but you have to be careful. Read the question properly, whether it is a positive question or negative question. These are again keywords, and we have some more keywords, that is none, two, which starts with capital letter. Rest of the other words are small letters. Now, what is an identifier? What are the different identifier naming conventions, Meenakshi?
A Python identifier is a name given to a function, class, variable, module, or other objects that you'd be using in your Python program. In short, it's a name appeared in the program. For example, A, B, and C are identifiers, and A, B, the symbol C and symbol and C are tokens.
Okay, when we say it as A, B, and C, they are tokens, but they are identifiers also. Different identifier naming conventions. You don't have to read it. You know what are the different identifier rules. Which are they? Meenakshi, it should not start with a number or any other special characters. Okay, that is the first rule. You can't use keyword as the to give identified names. Then there should not be any space in between, and special characters are not allowed. It can start with an underscore. So these are the different naming rules that are specified here. It's a case sensitive language. The small letter A is different from capital lettering. That's another one. Underscores can be used. So valid identifiers, invalid identifiers. Why this is not considered as an identifier? Because it is a keyword. Keyword. False. Then literal. Literal is constant values, isn't it? It's a constant value. These are the different types of literals that you have, you know, already. This is what I told you. This is a special literal. None. There's no dot. Then literal collection. All right. Now string. It can be enclosed in quotes. Can be enclosed in single quotes or both are same. And it has two types of indices. One is positive index. And the one is negative index. Positive index starts with 0, negative index starts with -1. So if you want to retrieve any character in the string, you have to write. What will be the value, Donna?
0.
S of 0, what is this? What is it?
H.
S of -12, Rona?
That is H.
So it can have a positive index or negative index. Same thing, S of 0, H. If you are asking the user enter a string, then if you want to retrieve the last character from the string, you can write in this way. This len is a function which is used to find the length of the string. So if you write len in bracket s, then you will get the result as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 is the total length. And the last character is there in the index position 11, that is 12 minus 1. That is why it is written len s minus 1. All right, len is a function, inbuilt function in Python. And space is a character. It should be counted as a character. This minus one. So you can express this characters in two ways. One is in single quotes or double quotes. Then this you can read, Donna.
Multiple line strings, strings created using single quote or double quote and spread across multiple lines are called multi-line strings. By adding backslash, one can continue to type on the next line.
So this keyboard can be typed in two ways in your window. Item is equal to keyboard. This is the first method. If you want to write it in two lines, you have to write a backslash. Suppose you are not writing the backslash, then Python will give you an error message if you write in the in two lines keyboard. All right. And if you want to find the length of keyboard, then it won't count the backslash because this backslash is an escape sequence. So suppose there is no space between keyboard. What is the length?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the length of this? Length of this?
7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Zero number.
Length. Count the number of items. So index is different, length is different. Understood? Length means count the number of characters. If you count the number of characters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay.
If I ask you what is the index of B, then you can say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Length is the number of items. Index, the position starts always with 0. That is why you can't say 7 items. 7 character is the length. 8 is the length. So my question is, what is the length of this? This length is also 8. Because even though we'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, this backslash should not be counted, as it is a support character for writing in a new line, escape sequence. All right. So that's why if you write in this way, what is the length of this? It's 1. 1 backslash is considered as an escape sequence. 3, 2. Here, the slash is behaving as an escape sequence. So that's why the size is 30. So when we use in this way, Rama's laptop, if I want to print in bracket, Rama's laptop in this way, it will give you an error message because double quotes or single quotes is considered as enclosing for string values. It will give you an error message. Three quotes are given. The Python will get confused with which is the ending of the quote, which is the starting of the quote. So in order to make this inside you as the output, that means in the display window, you need to write in this way. Then it will not give you an error message and your output will be exactly this. Rama's So in that case, you have to use a escape sequence. So it should not be counted for the length. Now, there's one more string that is called as multi-line strings. So multi-line strings are used for writing comments in your program, multi-line comments. And it is also called as, triple quoted strings are also called as doc strings. Okay, and you can write X, Y, Z. Now, what is the length of the string? This length of the string is not 3. The length of the string is 5. How? In triple quoted strings, instead of slash, we use enter key. So you type X, then you press the enter key, isn't it? That enter key is considered as a character. So this is the first character, enter key is the second character. And in the next line, we typed Y, then pressed enter. So this is the third character, enter key is the fourth character, then the fifth character. So size is 5. Only this is applicable only in the case of triple quoted strings. All right. If you want to display a single quote, you have to write in this way. If you want to display a slash, you have to write 2 slashes. If you want to display a double quote, you have to start with a slash. This you know, escape sequence, slashing, slash R, slash T. This is it's like an enter key, slash R, horizontal tab. Then literals. And we can say, Vipul, what is the format of a complex number? A plus?
A plus YJ.
YJ. And that is in Python. X plus, right?
Yeah, X plus YJ.
YJ. In normal math, it is X plus. In Python it is J. That's it. So I have told you only about decimal integer literals. Decimal values means we can use 10 values, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That is why it is called as decimal number system. We are using 10 numbers. Color is dull. It's looking like a page of color. Okay. And octal literals means you can use 8 numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you use only 8 numbers, it is called as octal integers. And if you simply write 7 in your Python coding, it will be considered as concentration has gone. If you write 7 simply, it will be considered as a normal integer value. In order to make it as an octal, you have to add 2 things. One is 0, O. Then it will be considered as an octal number. Hexadecimal integer means you can use numbers, 16 numbers you can use. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. If we use 16 numbers, then it is called as a hexadecimal number. So you don't have to study much. But this 10 onwards, we will write as A, B, C, D, E, F. So if you want to write an hexadecimal number in your programming, then you have to write 0xA3. Then this will be considered as a hexadecimal number. That you will see it in the next year. Okay. Don't have to worry about this. So there are two types of numbers, octal integer and hexadecimal integer. This also you don't have to study much. Fractional form, real numbers that you know. The other one you leave. Then you have a Boolean literal that you know already. It returns only true or false. So if I print question to you with whole, print 3 greater than 4. What will be the result?
False.
It will return false. Okay, and F will be capital letter. So that's what. Then this is a special literal, none. N-O-N-E. That means like your SQL, null, nothing. Absence of a value. But in Python, it is called as N-O-N-E, none. Then we have a literal collection. Under literal collections, tuple, list, dictionary, etc. Set. All right. That is literal collections. Then what is an operator, Donna?
Operators are tokens that trigger some computation when applied to a variable. What is a unary operator? Unary operators are those operators that require one operand to operate upon. Unary operators, unary plus, unary minus, bitwise complement, logical negation.
So this is called positive, plus four. So this is a unary operator. What is the meaning of plus four? Positive four. Isn't it? So we are applying only, or like plus one into four. Usually we'll do in that way. Minus five. Then not five. So we are applying only on one operand. And it's called unary operator. Binary operator, Vithur, you can read.
Binary operators are those operators that require two operands to operate upon. Binary operators, plus addition, minus subtraction, star multiplication, slash division, percentage remainder or modulus. Two stars exponent, two slash floor division.
Continue.
Shift operators, and bitwise and. What is that, ma'am? Symbol.
Exclusive. This you can see on the keyboard. This one, right?
Yes, ma'am.
This, check the keyboard. Okay. Left side, top.
Yes, ma'am. Six.
That's like, sometimes you'll use an exponent form, or you can, in Python, we'll use it as a exclusive OR. That is the something called exclusive OR, XOR.
Bitwise OR. Shift operators, two less than symbol, left.
It's called that shift left, shift right. You continue.
Relational operators, less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, not equal to. Logical operators, and, or, not. Assignment operators, equal to assignment operators, star equal to assigned product.
One example.
A star equal to B.
What's the meaning of that?
A into B.
The same way you have, you can use any, it's called a shorthand operator, shorthand operators.
Membership operators. In, whether variable in sequence, not in, whether variable not in sequence.
So we use this in for loop, isn't it? In. So it is a, or another question to you, Vithur. What would be the result? True or false?
True.
True. So the question is like 3 in 431, 432 question mark. Whether 3 is present in this particular list. Just go through this. You don't have to read it. What is this? This you will study next year. What is this? This is called as a function. Don't have to worry about it. It's a command. Command. This is a function. This is another function. How to write a program. That's what it is called. There are two types of comments, single line and multiple line, multi-line comments. Multi-line comment starts with dash, Vithur.
Triple quotes.
Triple quotes. Triple apostrophe is also called as dog strings that I have told you before. A program is called is also called as a code. Function, you don't have to worry about it. The maximum line length you can write in a single line. The maximum characters allowed is 79. Okay, just try it out. Only maximum 79, then it will go to the next one. Is case sensitive? Variables, how the variable allocation is happening. Okay. Marks and reference. Marks is equal to 86. Next time, if you write marks as it's equal to, marks is equal to hello, then what happens? Hello, this will go and the point will be referring to, it will be referring to, the arrow will be referring to hello. That's what happens. This speciality of Python program is called as dynamic. That's why Python is called as a dynamic language. First line, it was integer. Next line, it became a string. Mark became string. So it was 86 before, now it changed to 81. See, the 86 is stored in location 2054. Okay, next line it is changed to 2026. So it does not have a fixed location. Suppose this was your C coding or C++ coding. Then what will happen is, this is the memory location, mark will be having a fixed place, that is suppose 2026, and the value will come here. And the first time it was 81. So what is the value, what is the memory address of marks? 2026. Any doubt in that? This is I'm telling about C or C++ or Java. Then next time when I change this value to 86, what happens? 81 will go and 86 will come. If you display the address of marks, it will remain same, that is 2026. But here, the case is, first it was 86. If we display the memory address of marks, it will display 2054. The next time we wrote marks is equal to 81. This time, if you display the memory address of marks, it will display 2026. So the meaning is that variables in Python do not have a fixed location, unlike other programming languages. All right. When you write A is equal to 10, this is called your L value, left value. This is called R value, right value, RHS. Letters. This is possible only and only in Python. In normal pure mathematics, we'll write. Why are you smiling? Because we will continue the next class. Okay. Bye bye. Thank you.